What's up, everybody? Sam here. Java, is it worth learning today, especially with all the new emerging programming languages? The way I like to evaluate decisions like this is by listing out the pros, listing out the cons, comparing them, and at the end of the video, I'm going to give you guys my opinion. So a lot of you are asking what IDE I use for Java, and I use IntelliJ, which is developed by JetBrains. And I love their products, so today I wanted to tell you guys about JetBrains Academy, which is the sponsor of this video. JetBrains Academy is a project-based learning platform where you can learn to program by building fully functional applications with more than 110 projects to choose from. You first choose your track. There are several to choose from, such as Java, Python, Kotlin, and more. Then you select a project based on your learning level. Projects are split into different stages. For each stage, you learn concepts related to that stage and then apply those concepts to the project. There's also seamless IDE integration, so you can use the powerful features of JetBrains IDEs. The knowledge map shows you all the topics in that track and the connections between them. You can select any topic to learn more about it. Finally, you can upload your finished projects to GitHub and strengthen your development portfolio. So use this link right here to get your first month completely free, and I'll also leave a link down in the description. So we're not gonna go in depth with what Java is, but just to quickly recap, it's a high-level programming language developed in 1995. It's one of the most popular languages in the world. It's open source. It runs on pretty much every operating system. It's used to build everything from Android apps to server networks to video games. So needless to say, it's a very powerful and versatile language. So let's start with the pros. Java embraces object-oriented programming. It was basically a rebuild of C++. However, with C++, they basically took C and slapped the ability to have classes on there. This made the syntax and just the overall feel of using classes in C++ kind of awkward. Java was built from the ground up with classes in mind. Everything is an object, and it's just an overall cleaner implementation. So why is this a good thing? Well, it allows developers to easily reuse objects in their programs. It helps just the overall maintenance of your code. I have an entire video on object-oriented programming, so you guys should definitely check that out. But moving on to the second thing, it's platform independence. There's a famous saying in Java, write it once, run it anywhere. Java runs on top of a virtual machine, which is called, you guessed it, Java Virtual Machine, or JVM. So as long as the JVM is installed on a machine, you can run Java code. So you can write and run your code on a Windows machine, take that same code, run it on Mac or Linux. And really, technically, you can just take the bytecode, which is compiled Java code, and run that on a JVM running on any machine. So you don't even really need the original source code. With Java, you also get automated memory management. Now, if you're coming from a language like Python, you're gonna be like, yeah, what's the big deal? But if you're like me and your first language was C++ or C, this is an amazing feature. So what does this mean? Well, if your program is running, you might need extra memory. In a language like C or C++, once you're done using that memory, you need to deallocate the space back. And forgetting to do this will cause memory leaks in your program. In a language like Java, once a chunk of code is no longer referenced, there's something called a garbage collector that runs and will automatically deallocate that for you. So the automated memory management just adds an extra safety net and just less steps that you have to do manually. Java has built-in support for multi-threading. This means that you can have multiple threads running concurrently. A thread is just a unit of a process that can perform an action. And the fact that Java has this built into it, and in my opinion, built into it very well, just gives it a huge advantage over other languages. And the last pro is that it's a very mature language. Java has survived for a few decades now. It has a great community. It's backed by Oracle, and they've really kept it up to date with features of competing languages like C# and Kotlin. It seems like when one of these languages come out with a new feature, in the next Java update, they've, you know, built something similar. And the Oracle website has some of the best documentation I've seen for a language. The frameworks and libraries have been very well tested, and it's a language that's just probably gonna be around for a long time. All right, so those are the pros of learning Java. Let's take a look at some of the cons. The first con is that it's losing popularity. Now, although it is such a widely used language, I do believe that its popularity will start to decline slowly over the years. Now, it's not something that's gonna happen overnight, But, you know, you have a lot of newer languages that are coming out. It's like Go and Rust that are gaining popularity. The university that I was studying at, they used to do their intro courses in Java. They moved over to Python. And I think that's a trend that a lot of universities are going to pick up on. And you think of Android, which solely use Java. Now they're moving away to start using Kotlin. So here on the left, we have the Stack Overflow developer survey from 2017. And on the right, we have it from 2020. We see in 2017, it was the third most popular language. 2020, it went down to fifth. Now, although it is slightly higher, like 0.5%, we see the other mainstream languages like JavaScript went up from 62 to 67%. We see Python went from 32 to 44%. So even though it went up like 0.5%, I do kind of see it kind of like, you know, reaching its peak, and I feel like it's going to start declining over the years. The next con is that it's a very verbose language, meaning you have to write a lot of code to do a little. Verbose languages are meant to be very like declarative, and it's supposed to be very clear what you're doing. But in my opinion, it makes the code a little bit cluttered and actually harder to read. And it may not seem like a big deal to, you know, you're just typing a little bit more, but if you're writing Java code like all day, every day, it can get quite tedious and honestly a little bit obnoxious, especially when you compare it to a language like Python. Like you see here on the left how much code there is versus the guy she tells you not to worry about. Obviously, this is an exaggerated example, but you get the point. And finally, Java is a pretty slow language. Remember how I mentioned Java runs on a virtual machine? Well, this layer of abstraction slows things down. Virtual machines act as an operating system running on top of another operating system. So there's a lot of overhead there. The further away the software is from the hardware, the slower the performance, especially when you compare it to a language like C++, which is very close to the hardware. Anything where you need real-time operations like online gaming or like a car's operating system, Java just isn't really going to be a good choice for that. We also mentioned the garbage collector. Well, when that runs, your entire program suspends. Then the garbage collector runs and then the program resumes. Now, this is only a fraction of a second and users really aren't going to notice it. But again, if you're really looking for a speedy application, it does take a slight performance hit. So with that being said, is Java still worth learning today? Now, you know, it obviously depends on what you're looking to get into. But in general, I still think it's a really good language. There's still a huge community behind it. Obviously, it's backed by a massive company in Oracle. And obviously, Oracle isn't going anywhere anytime soon. And yeah, I think it's just a great language to pick up, whether you're a beginner learning your first language or just a more experienced developer looking to add to your toolbox. So I want to know your opinion. Do you think Java is still worth learning right now? Let me know in the comments. Also, if you'd like to join the Keep On Coding Discord server where you can connect with a lot of other developers, there's a link to that down in the description. It's totally free. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, keep on coding.